Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain vagal tone in detail along with the molecular mechanism of the vagal tone. I am going to explain the vagal tone with the innervation of the SA node. Sinoatrial node, which is the SA node, is the pacemaker of the human heart, and SA node generates impulses around 60 to 100 times per minute. Now the SA node innervation. SA node is innervated by sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system, which are parts of autonomic nervous system. So SA node is innervated by the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system innervates the SA node from the right vagus nerve. Always in resting condition, there are some discharge of sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems are present, which modifies the firing activity of SA node and hence the heart rate. So at the resting condition, both the sympathetic tone is also there and parasympathetic tone is also there. Tone, that means resting activity of the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Here the sympathetic nervous system acts on the SA node via the noradrenaline neurotransmitter, and parasympathetic nervous system acts on the SA node via the acetylcholine neurotransmitter. Only SA node activity. In humans, when both the sympathetic and parasympathetic systems are blocked, the heart rate is approximately 100 beats per minute. So when both the sympathetic activity as well as parasympathetic activity both are blocked, the heart rate is around 100 beats per minute. SA node activity modified by sympathetic tone only. After the administration of parasympatholytic drugs. Now what is parasympatholytic drugs? Which blocks or opposes the action of parasympathetic nervous system, that means cancellation of the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system. After the administration of parasympatholytic drugs such as atropine, the heart rate in human 150 to 180 beats per minute. So once the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system has been blocked, there will be activity of the sympathetic nervous system has been dominating, so that the heart rate will become 150 to 180 beats per minute. Why? Because the sympathetic tone is unopposed and there is moderate amount of tonic discharge takes place in the cardiac sympathetic nerve at the rest. So as I just told you that once you block the parasympathetic nervous system activity, there will be domination of the sympathetic activity and the heart rate will be increased around 150 to 180 beats per minute. That is the sympathetic nervous system activity only, without parasympathetic activity. All right. Parasympathetic tone, it is the vagal tone, because the parasympathetic nervous system supplying the SA node through the right vagus nerve. So that's why the parasympathetic tone, or we can also use the word vagal tone. So here the parasympathetic tone or the vagal tone dominates the sympathetic tone. There is a good deal of tonic vagal discharge or the vagal tone in humans, which overcome the resting sympathetic tone. Hence the heart rate is 70 beats per minute. Activity of the sympathetic nervous system has been blocked, partially blocked by the parasympathetic nervous system, which is maintained by the vagus nerve, specifically right vagus nerve on the pacemaker cells of the SA node, and hence here we are using the word vagal tone dominates the sympathetic tone, and that's why the heart rate decreased to 70 beats per minute. Without vagal tone, the heart rate is 150 to 180 beats per minute, but due to continuous activity of the parasympathetic nervous system, it partially blocks the sympathetic nervous system activity, or simply sympathetic tone, and hence the heart rate is 70 beats per minute. And it's also noting that the person who having the cardiac abnormality having the higher sympathetic tone, and the dominating activity of the parasympathetic nervous system has been decreased. In simple words, when the vagal tone is decreased, the activity or the abnormality of the heart become increased. Now, how the activity of the sympathetic nervous system is regulated in the SA node, and how the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system has been regulated. So first we are going through the sympathetic activity. Sympathetic activity is regulated by the neurotransmitter noradrenaline. when the noradrenaline binds to the beta 1 receptor of the sympathetic nervous system, it activates or it stimulates the protein G or the G protein. So once the G protein is stimulated, it stimulates the adenyl cyclase enzyme. And this adenyl cyclase enzyme converts ATP to CAMP, ATP adenosine triphosphate, and CAMP, that means cyclic adenosine monophosphate. Once ATP is converted to CAMP, this CAMP activates the protein kinase A, and this protein kinase A in turn activates the ICA type of channels of the calcium influx channels. So that's why the activity of this channel becomes increased, or the channel becomes opens, and that's the reason why there is a calcium influx takes place inside the SA node. So that is the sympathetic activity only without any parasympathetic domination. Okay, now the parasympathetic activity, which is mainly from the right vagus nerve. Here the neurotransmitter, it is the acetylcholine. So when the acetylcholine binds with the muscarinic receptor, here the specifically M2 receptor, and it having the two types of activity. In the first event, it stimulates the inhibitory protein G. And so once the inhibitory protein G is activated, it in turn inhibits the adenyl cyclase, so that there will not be any conversion of ATP to CAMP, no activity of the protein kinase A, and no opening of the calcium channel. So calcium channel remains blocked. Okay, so that is the first event. In the second event, inhibitory protein G activates the potassium channels through which the potassium ion will escape from the cell, and hence there is decrease in the potassium ion inside the cell. Now here the two major activities occurring at this point, specifically to block or to partially block the activity of the sympathetic tone or the sympathetic nervous system at the SA node. So which are the two activities? First, hyperpolarizing SA node, increased time required to depolarize the threshold. So hyperpolarizes, that means this one, efflux of potassium ion, so that the hyperpolarization of the SA nodal cells, and hence the time required to depolarize to the threshold level becomes increased. And second, decrease CAMP level, because here it blocks the activity of the adenyl cyclase, and obviously due to this blockage of the adenyl cyclase activity, it decrease the CAMP level, so that it decrease activation of the target proteins as well as the calcium channels. So both of these are the reason why the parasympathetic activity or the activity of the vagal tone dominates over the activity of the sympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, both activity are there, but sympathetic activity is 40% is present and parasympathetic activity around 60%. That means domination of the parasympathetic activity over the sympathetic activity. Both of these activities are must or necessary to maintain the heart rate at the normal level. But when the parasympathetic activity is blocked, the sympathetic activity becomes dominating, which will be the reason behind the many type of heart disease. But here normally parasympathetic activity dominates the sympathetic activity, which is known as vagal tone. When we speak about the activity of the vagal tone, we are speaking about the parasympathetic dominating activity over the SA node, over the heart, and hence the heart rate has been controlled to up to 72 beats per minute on average. So that is the reason of the domination of the vagus activity, which is known as vagal tone. So here when only the activity of SA nerve is present, the heart rate will be around 60 to 100 beats per minute. SA nerve activity, which is modified by sympathetic tone only the sympathetic tone is present, which modifies the activity of the SA nerve, then heart rate will be 150 to 180 beats per minute. When SA node activity is modified by sympathetic and vagal tone, then heart rate around 70 beats per minute. here vagal tone dominating effect over the sympathetic tone. That's why the heart rate is maintained to average 70 beats per minute. Now here we are speaking about the vagal tone, so we must have to speak about the vagus nerve. And vagus nerve, specifically we have to speak about the brainstem nuclei of the vagus nerve. So cardiac vagal activity is generated by the populations of vagal preganglionic neurons residing in two brainstem nuclei. Which are the brainstem nuclei of the vagus nerve? So first nuclei, it is the dorsal vagal motor nucleus. And the second nuclei, it is the nucleus ambiguus. These two distinct populations of neuron have different patterns of discharge and provide different control of the cardiac function. So both of these activity of the this one dorsal vagal motor nucleus and the nucleus ambiguus having the different activity and differently control the cardiac function. So first, neurons of the nucleus ambiguus are rhythmic, entered by the neighboring respiratory network and appear to exclusively control the nodal tissues and therefore the heart rate. Now the second nucleus, vagal preganglionic neurons residing in the dorsal vagal motor nucleus displays a tonic pattern of discharge without afferent impulses from the periphery and the CNS. So this could be the reason why the vagal tone is present. I hope via this presentation now you are able to understand what is vagal tone, how vagal tone dominates over the sympathetic discharge or sympathetic tone, and what is the molecular mechanism of the vagal tone. If you like this presentation, please try to share it with your friends, group, batch and colleagues. Thank you so much, everyone.